Hello everyone, welcome to the ASP.NET MVC tutorial. So this is my fourth tutorial. So before proceeding, I would like to suggest you to watch my previous videos, that is part 1, 2 and 3. So in the previous videos, I was just discussed about the controller view and the routing concept. So now in this tutorial, I will discuss about the model. So now open your Visual Studio. So you can see in the previous videos, I have just created a test controller. In test controller, I was just returning a list in a view back name list. And I was just showing this list in a view. So now I'm gonna add a model and we'll show this same list. Now just first thing, just delete that, and now I'm just gonna delete this too. And now I have just created an employee table and it has three columns: employee ID, name and department. And now I'm gonna add a model. So click on model folder, click on add and add a class, and name it employee and add. Okay, so I have added employee class. So now I will just create employee ID. So just write public int employee ID, say, and put a get set. And now copy this and second is name and department. So I am just gonna rename it and employee and department. So now I'm gonna build this application. So now this model is just referencing a table name and its column name. So now in the view, I'm just gonna use it. So just put a @ and use a model and put a space and write your project name MVC tutorial dot models dot. If you see, you have created your employee model, so put employee. And now go to your controller and create a list. Create a list of employee. Now you can see it's not referencing, so just right click and resolve this. So it will add a library, so it's referencing employee, like employees, employee list. I'm gonna name it employee list equals to new employee list. And now again I'm gonna create a class employee equals to new employee. Now close it, you can see. And here I will just add item in employee list. So in employee list dot add, I'm gonna add new employee. So you will get the reference. So I will give employee ID equals to 1, comma, name equals to Ashish, and now I'm gonna write the department equals to IT. Okay, so you can see represent a class or Unicode converter. So just go to your model. I now make it a string. So here an ID is int and rest things are, and now just copy it and paste it. Now change your ID to 3, 4, and now put it John, Sarah, and Rio. And let's see department, maybe anything like this, quality assurance. So put a QA, and inventory you can add inventory, and now sales. So you can put a sales department. Now I'm gonna just pass it into this model. Okay, so now it will return a view by having the list of record. And now if you see this employee medal, so I need, it's consisting a list, so I will just take it a enable and just make it this. So it's consisting a lot of records. So now I'm gonna add a table consisting a tr. Now I'm gonna add a table header th. Now here I will show the ID field, it and copy 3 times. Paste. And now I will show the name here, and I will show the department here. So now I will add a T body. I will just add a TR. So before that I will put @ if, again if model is not equal to null, because it will throw an exception if it is null, then do following things and put a @ for each. Where item in model. So now you will see the suggestion. So I'm gonna add a row with having TD. First TD is now item. So put a @item dot, you will see your department ID, employee ID and name. So I will just put employee ID and now again I will just use another td, and now I will just put item dot so in second fill I am just showing the name, and now again in td I am just going to show employee dot your department name. Control KD. So now let's run the application. So now with the model you can see various property suggestion. So here you can see your list ID, name and department. So now again I'm gonna just put a class name. So if you don't know about the Bootstrap, so you can also go to my Bootstrap tutorial. So table is stripped. Okay, now just press F5, and now this is your ID, name and department. Now you can put a style, and now you can put a minimum width, let's see, 60%. So now control F5. So this is your list, and you can match it with your database. So you can so this table with the help of model. So here I have completed all this model, controller and view. So now in the next video session I will just discuss about the view bag, view data, and how can you connect your database to the ASP.NET MVC, and you also will be able to show the list, and form posting will be there, and you can dynamically add some item in the list. So we will see in a later video session. So thank you very much for watching my tutorial, and keep sharing, and if you really like it then give us a thumbs up, comment and subscribe. Thank you very much and have a great day.